Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. Today I was going to try to turn a hollow form out of this piece of red oak. I picked up this red oak about 4 years ago, planning on making a hearth with it. The piece was 4.5 inches thick, 6 feet long, and never ended up doing that. So now I've cut it into blanks for either salad bowls or hollow forms. So when I bought this, the fella told me that it was around 100 years old. Now, whether it is or not, I'm not sure, but anyway, we'll see what this turns out like. I'm gonna start out with a 5/8 inch gouge with a 40-40 grind. Start to shape this. You can see how smooth this 40-40 grind cuts across this end grain on this piece of oak. Leaves it very nice. Now I'm just going to drill a 7/8 inch hole down here. We'll take a measurement and see how deep we want to go. I'll just put a mark on the drill bit here and just remember when you're doing this, so you take into account the tip on your bit, so you don't go through the bottom of your piece with a little tiny hole. I'm gonna move my headstock out this way a little bit to make it a little easier. Now we'll start to hollow this out. There we go, now we'll sand this up. you guys probably don't want to see a bunch of sanding, so we'll come back when we're putting the finish on it. Okay, guys, we're back. We sanded this down to 320 grit, and I've applied a coat of homemade sanding paste. So we're going to polish it off. So now at this point, you can decide what finish you want to put on it. You could actually just put a wax finish on top of this and it would be very nice, but I'm going to use a OB shine. So I think with the OB shine on here, it's going to bring this out so it looks almost like a fisheye look. Listen to it. So I just put this on to protect the ways on my lathe. So that's one coat. There's the second coat. Now you can put on as many coats as you like to the desired shine you like. I'll probably put on two more here. But you can see the shine on that. Well, there we go. I'm going to make a small finial for the top of this. I'm just going to use a piece of maple, which will be a lighter color, which will contrast with the red oak. This is about a 2-inch square piece of maple. This is just a 1-inch roughing gouge. Measure the opening here. And parting tool. What size is this? Go. can hear I got a little bit of chatter in the end of this, so my tailstock up. That'll eliminate that. Now when you're turning these, you can put any detail you want, or you can put as much detail in or as little detail in, whatever you like. There we go. Now I'm going to double check my measurements here. Might take a little bit more off. So there we go. I mean, you can make these however long you want them, however fancy you want them. See that this one doesn't quite fit in there, so we'll just take some sandpaper and sand it off a little bit. There we go, much quicker. And there we go. Don't know how useful this is, but it's a pretty little object. Pretty good. Thanks, guys. Don't forget to hit the like button and the subscribe, and see you next time around.